When it is said that a man has been faithful to a woman's memory, it generally means that he couldn't get anyone else to take him." "That isn't the case with Peter," protested Louisa. "He is a good match, and many a woman would have been glad to take him, and would yet. He's only 43, but he's never taken the slightest interest in anyone since you threw him over, Nancy." "But I didn't. He threw me over," said Nancy plaintively, looking afar over the low-lying fields and a feathery young spruce valley to the white buildings of the Wright farm, glowing rosily in the sunset light when all the rest of Avonlea was scarfing itself in shadows. There was laughter in her eyes. Louisa could not pierce beneath that laughter to find if there were anything under it. "Fudge," said Louisa. "What on earth did you and Peter quarrel about?" she added curiously. "I've often wondered," parried Nancy. "And you've never seen him since?" reflected Louisa. "No. Has he changed much?" "Well, some. He is gray and kind of tired-looking, but it isn't to be wondered at, living the life he does. He hasn't had a housekeeper for 2 years, not since his old aunt died. He just lives there alone and cooks his own meals. I've never been in the house, but folks say the disorder is something awful." "Yes, I shouldn't think Peter was cut out for a tidy housekeeper," said Nancy lightly, dragging up more mint. "Just think, Louisa, if it hadn't been for that old quarrel, I might be Mrs. Peter Wright at this very moment, mother to the aforesaid supposed half-dozen, and vexing my soul over Peter's meals and socks and cows." "I guess you are better off as you are," said Louisa. "Oh, I don't know." Nancy looked up at the white house on the hill again. "I have an awfully good time out of life, but it doesn't seem to satisfy somehow. To be candid, and oh, Louisa, candor is a rare thing among women when it comes to talking of the men. I believe I'd rather be cooking Peter's meals and dusting his house. I wouldn't mind his bad grammar now. I've learned one or two valuable little things out yonder, and one is that it doesn't matter if a man's grammar is askew, so long as he doesn't swear at you."